Hi, welcome to Inspire UI. This video will be showing you all the necessary steps in order to build ABA file in FluxBuilder. So without further ado, let's get straight into it. Okay, first thing first, let's start with creating authority or sign request certificate. First of all, open your keychain access and click on keychain access on the top left. Click on certificate assistant, request a certificate from a certificate authority. At this point, the system will display the certificate assistant form. Now enter your email and don't forget to click on save to disk and click on continue. Select a folder save all files. It's highly recommended that you should create a separate folder to save all the authentication files. Then click save. This is our signed report certificate. Okay, you have turned the certificate assistant file. Now open a web browser and start creating certificates. Go to Apple developer website and sign in with your developer account. After logging successfully, select account. When account dashboard appears, click on certificates, identifiers, and profiles. In certificates tab, click on the blue plus button. Define your software certificates as Apple distribution and press continue. At this step, select the certificate sign report that we have created in step 1. After successfully uploaded, now we can download our certificate files. And please save it in the folder that we have created in step 1. Now open keychain access and click open on the certificate that we just downloaded. Choose the key to filter the values. It's normally the one that has just had the arrow on the left recently. Check the certificate's information that is shown. If certificate with expires matches with the time it's generated, here's the file. And usually it will be 10 minutes earlier than when it was created. When you have already identified that key, right click on that line and click on the spot. Save the file in the folder we have created in step 1. After that, enter the password for the file. Remember, you will need this password to use for other later builds. Finally, enter your computer password as keychain access requires. When complete this step, we will have a rabbit key and a distribution certificate. Now it's time to create project provisioning. Now return to the main page and click on profiles. We will create a new provisioning here, but before that, we need to identify our app bundle ID. What I'm trying to do here is navigate to my project, find a runner, and open it by scope. Things might take a while. At the target runner, click on sign-in and capabilities. You can find your bundle identifier here, copy it, and navigate back to the Apple developer website. Click on the blue plus button next to profile to create provisioning. Select App Store distribution and click on continue. Now select an app identifier that matches with the one that we found in our previous step. Now choose the appropriate certificate. The little tips here for you to check the expiration date of all the options and choose the one that had the correct expiration date matching with your certificate. Then click on continue. Enter your revisioning profile name and click on generate. Then click download and save it in the folder that we have just created in step 1. Now we're going to create OneSignal revisioning. However, if your app doesn't include with OneSignal feature, you can skip this step. Please repeat all the previous steps just like we created provisioning for our project. However, you need to pay attention to the bundle identifier. It must match with OneSignal app ID instead of our project app ID. Enter the name for OneSignal provisioning profile. Then click on generate and download it. Save it into the folder which created in step 1. When we are done with this step, we will obtain two files, provisioning for our project and for OneSignal. So up to now, we have obtained all the necessary files in order to build ABA file. Now open your FluxBuilder. Choose your project. Click on Build Feature. Add IMS tab. Locate your project folder. Update your app name and app icon if needed, and then enter your computer password. Choose the private key certificate that we created in step 3 and enter the password. Now choose your project provisioning that we created in step 4. We will do the same for the provisioning for OneSignal. We created this file in step 5. Check on self local and click on install profile. When you see the congratulations message, click on next. Review all your apps information again. And if nothing is wrong, click on build iOS. The whole process could take up to 45 minutes, so please be patient. So we hope that this video could give you an overview about how build ABA file feature in FluxBuilder works. Besides, when using FluxBuilder in general and this feature in specific, if you get any issue, feel free to leave it as a support ticket. The technical team will come to give you a hand. So I think that's pretty much it. Thank you for watching.